Hi, my name is Nazanin Bassiri-Gharb, and I'm an assistant professor in the George W. Woodruff School of Mechanical Engineering at Georgia Tech. My primary research area is micro and nano engineering, and I also work on mechanics of materials. So I work on smart materials. So these are materials that respond to external stimuli. It could be an electric field, a thermal field, mechanical applications, stresses or strains. And I work at them in the small dimensions. So they have to be 10 to the minus 6 or 10 to the minus 9 or smaller dimensions with respect to anything large that you can see, things that you will see only under a microscope if you're lucky. So you can actually use these materials for energy applications, energy harvesting from the environment, or maybe in the fuel cells. So you can bring a lot of energy with you in a portable way. You can use them for healthcare applications. They are actually used for medical ultrasound devices, or possibly for security. They are used for terahertz emitters and sensors, but also for underwater sonars. So think of it about how the size of devices have changed over the last 10 to 15 years. Everything has become smaller. We want cell phones that are smaller, or tablets that maybe screens bigger, but the rest of it is smaller or weight less. So we are working on miniaturized devices or materials that would enable that miniaturization of the devices themselves. So the idea is that there are a lot of cool things that could be done with these materials. But A, we don't know how to process them at a small scale. And B, we don't really know how the materials are going to behave once they have become so small. So what my group does is A, work into manufacturing them in a scale that is compatible for those very, very small dimensions. And B, try to understand how the material behaves at those small dimensions and therefore enable the fabrication of the devices and the design of them. If somebody asks me why I'm doing what I'm doing, I can tell them by chance, but that's not all of it. My dad once told me you can do anything you want, or anybody can do whatever they want if they just set their mind to it. And yes, chance dictated a lot of my pathway to where I am right now, but I think if you become really passionate about what you do, and learning is always about passion, you can go wherever you want. Who inspires me in my field? There is a short answer and a long answer. I can give it historically. It's Marie Curie. She received two Nobel Prizes. That seems kind of lofty in terms of, you know, what do I aspire in to? But she actually discovered radioactivity, and her husband and her brother-in-law discovered piezoelectricity. This is what the materials that I work on do. The shorter, or I guess more recent answer is that my colleagues inspire me. There are a lot of wonderful people that do awesome research out there. And I read their papers and say, wow, this is so fantastic. I want to be able to publish something like that. Now, every now and then I do it, but you know, it's like having some good, healthy competition. Those people inspire me. I received in 2013 an NSF Career Award from the Division of Materials Research at National Science Foundation. The Career Awards are given to younger researchers, faculty members, before they get tenured, for example, to establish their area of research, to become better at what they do. The award finances our research for the next 5 years, and well, it's relatively prestigious. Georgia Tech is unique because it's tech. It's so big. There is so many people that do so much cool research. You will always find somebody that will do something with you that would be so much more interesting and unique in terms of possibilities that pretty much you won't find anywhere else. Why you should come to Georgia Tech? Well, I guess the obvious answer is you're a top 5 ranked engineering school. Pretty much all engineering programs are in the top 10 in the country, but you would really get to work with a lot of smart people that are also cool. And I'm not sure you can say that about a lot of other places.